For we know that things can change. We know that technology based on the use of highly polluting fossil, especially coal, needs to be progressively replaced without delay. Reducing greenhouse gases requires honesty, courage, and responsibility. We believers cannot fail to ask God for a positive outcome through the present.
Sacramento is serious about modeling energy stewardship and instilling future generations with a love of creation. Its kindergarten through eighth grade school updated all its light fixtures, dating from 1927, and bulbs to 100% LED, including interior and exterior floodlights and signage. Lights on the stairwells have light sensors. The air conditioning system was changed from radiant heat from boilers to a slim unit, an in-and-out pipe and return system that uses no ducts, dramatically reducing leakage and energy use. The school put three huge exhaust fans, similar to whole house fans, on the roof of the parish hall and gym. Exterior windows employ ultraviolet coating. The school also sends parents notices and information electronically, further reducing the need for paper. Beyond its energy efficiency improvements, St. Francis School is a place where children get to interact with God's creation. The grass in the school garden has been converted to four planter beds with vegetables on drip irrigation that the students tend. Each week, the children clean their desks and recycle as much as possible. Recycle bins abound on the campus, and there is no bottled water at the school. Last year, the second grade class adopted 22 manatees as a class project, and now the kindergarten through fifth grade classes have adopted their own animals to sponsor. True to its name and mission, the three-story school has a mural in the stairwell, starting on the top floor and ending at the bottom, illustrating St. Francis's prayer, Canticle of the Creatures, Care for Creation, and on the main floor, the Sacramento-San Joaquin Delta. Its student learning expectations include respect and responsibility for creation. One of the elected positions on the student council is an environmental commissioner, integrating ecological principles with school curriculum within the student body and administration. St. Francis's principal, Ivan Erga, lifts up the example of historical Catholic saints by saying, "We try to carry out the mission of St. Francis and St. Clare of Assisi in everything we do." Congratulations to St. Francis of Assisi Catholic Parish in Sacramento for your exemplary work bringing up the next generation of climate caretakers. Betsy Rife Snyder and other members of St. Francis Parish of Sacramento are here to receive their cool climate award for engagement.
Whatever divine entity you believe in, we all matter to each other. And it's Pope Francis said and called us, we have a responsibility to each other and to the future. And I know that everyone here is probably doing something to cut their carbon emissions and to help save this incredibly beautiful creation. But I think we can do more. Whatever we're doing, we can do more. And so I leave you tonight with the desire in your heart to make sure that whatever you're doing, whatever the behavior is, coffee you drink, clothes you wear, energy you use, the car you drive, everything you do affects the behavior somewhere around the world. So having your mind, is what I'm doing helpful for the environment, or might I be harming a neighbor in some part of the world? And just keep that in your mind. Together, we can save this planet. We can turn around this warming trend, and we'll all be here with our children and our grandchildren and our spirit forever and ever. And some kind of practical things we can do. The Interfaith Power and Light campaign has been invited to go to Paris and give a presentation on what the faith community is doing in Nicaragua. We have asked our congregations and people like you to take a pledge. It's called the Paris Pledge. We're going to take your names and your congregation names to the State Department at the Blue Zone, the official zone of the United Nations negotiation tent. And we're going to stand up and say, these congregations and these people have committed and pledged to try to cut their carbon emissions 50% by 2030 and be carbon neutral by 2050. And these cuts are actually larger than what the United States government has pledged to do. We're going to say, we are doing it, and some of our congregations are already carbon neutral. We are doing it, we're saving money, we're creating jobs, we're saving creation, and we are putting ourselves out as examples for the 192 nations that are going to be in Paris in December and ask them to do the same thing. And it's a big stretch. I want to say one other thing, if there's any of you out there who are over 60 years old, you can, and you have no excuse not to take the Paris Pledge. I guarantee you that along with me, we will be carbon neutral by 2050.
This little